An entire sport. Today marks the Olympic debut of breaking. So we're getting some lessons in at the House of Dance over in Edina. Man, oh man, he's doing that with no hat on either. Just spinning on the top of his head.
That is incredible. We don't have any Minnesota athletes, unfortunately, but no. He should, like, that is sweet.
I can't wait to see Minnesota Joe, though.
Whenever. Minnesota Joe.
Hopefully in the next Olympics.
All right, Alexis Rogers is there. We're going to check in with her in a little bit. Meantime, the weekend is upon us. And John, you're telling us to, like, earmark this weekend because it's going to be a stunner. It's going to be perfect.
Yes. John.
I was in awe of that man. I'm like, what? That was amazing. Let's get outside. It's 58 degrees out there right now. Again, we got some cloudy skies, but as we go into the afternoon, our temperatures will hold down a little bit because we got those northwest winds. So yesterday, if you liked yesterday, you're going to love today. I mean, it's the exact same day. So this morning, open them up, open the windows up, low 50s in Wilmer and St. Cloud, and you don't even need to shut the doors or the windows at all today because the wind is going to do the work for you. 10 to 15 mile per hour winds here today out of the northwest. Temperatures once again riding high in the upper 60s. We'll talk about when we get to the 70s and if it's going to rain again here in the next week.
Thank you. Just popping around on different traffic cameras here. 394 at Xenia Avenue. Traffic buzzing along in the Golden Valley area this morning. Let's give you a look in the South Metro 2. 169 at Old Shakopee Road. Traffic, drive times average there this morning. No need to leave early. Well, over now to the Olympics. There's just 3 days left of the competition in the 2024 Games.
Yeah, Michelle Beck is tracking what's been happening overnight, and she lets you know the big events to look out for the rest of the weekend. Hey, Michelle.
Guys, good morning to you. Well, you can see it right here. It is game day until 4 hours until the U.S. women's basketball team takes on Australia here in the semifinals. And this really is what it's all about. 60. This is for 60 consecutive Olympic games in a row, but more importantly, a spot in Sunday's Olympic gold medal game. Again, 28 minutes ago posted by USA Basketball here. And so we're so close to the Americans winning their unprecedented 8th consecutive gold medal here. So very much possible here. So meanwhile, for the men, their semifinals against Serbia was tough. Here they are yesterday, late in the third quarter, down 15. But they escaped that scare, and the U.S. beat Serbia 95-91. Hey, guys, some new sound that dropped in the last 40 minutes. Take a listen to Kevin Durant on their comeback win.
It means just as much to us just as it meant to them. And They're one of the best teams I ever played against in FIBA play, and you got to give them tons and tons of credit.
Yeah, and if Kevin Durant says this is one of the best teams he's ever played, he really means that you can believe him. Well, as LeBron James says here, there's just one more to go. The finals against host country France is tomorrow at 2:30. And guys, if Anthony Edwards and his teammates win, this would be U.S. men's basketball's 5th straight Olympic gold. So history in that sense, too.
That's going to be a fun matchup on Saturday. Cannot wait for that to tip off. Michelle, thank you. As we approach Sunday's closing ceremony, Team USA continues to widen the gap in the overall medal count.
That's right. And today there's plenty more opportunity to bring home some gold. Anne-Marie Tiernan is live in Paris with a look at what's ahead for Team USA. Good afternoon, Anne-Marie.
Well, good afternoon to you, Alicia and Jason. Yes, we really do have the Friday feels here, you know, some marquee events, and then the party's over with the closing ceremony. So there are some opportunities for gold today that include some team sports for red, white, and blue, and also in track and field. Let's take a look. In track and field, the U.S. go for double gold in the men's and women's 4x100 relay. The women are looking to reclaim the title from Jamaica, while it's been a 24-year gold medal drought for the men. In men's volleyball, the U.S. and Italy are squaring off in the bronze medal game. The Americans have not won this event since 2008. And in water polo, the U.S. and Serbia meet in the semis. The winner gets a shot at gold. The men have not medaled in this event since a silver at the 2008 Games in Beijing. And breaking is making its Olympic debut. Check out these athletes and their freestyle moves. It's a two-day competition with the women competing today. The men compete tomorrow. And I want to say it's been a real privilege to be able to bring you these live reports from Paris. And I just would like to raise a glass to KARE and to everyone in Minneapolis, really being a key part of this Olympics with the USA Gymnastics hosting the trials there at the end of June. So here's to you, and may Team USA continue to win. We have a bottle of champagne for you. We'll be sending that to you, courtesy Anne-Marie and all of us here at TEGNA. Back to you, aww, Alicia and Jason. Au revoir.
We are raising a glass to you as well, Anne-Marie, and we will be looking out for that bottle of champagne. We're holding you to it. Thank you for all your reporting. Thank you for all your reporting over the last couple of weeks. We appreciate it.
Merci beaucoup. Mm-hmm. There you go.
Merci beaucoup.
There you go. This morning, though, kicking off a busy weekend here at home in the Twin Cities, and there are several downtown projects that might impact your weekend plans. Our Audrey Russo is live in St. Paul with what you need to know. Hey, Audrey.
Hey, Alicia. Yeah, a lot of fun to be had this weekend in St. Paul, but you're going to need the luck of the Irish to navigate a lot of these construction projects. Not only are there three home games for the St. Paul Saints and the Lower Town Farmers Market, but there's also a three-day Irish festival that's coming to Harriet Island. The gates for that opening in about 9 hours from now. Take a look at this map. Let me show you what I mean when it comes to these construction projects. You can see the access to Harriet Island is very much limited. Three areas of concern I want to point out. Old Six near St. Peter, you can see some lane restrictions and some closures there. Cutting straight through the heart of downtown, you've got closures and restrictions on Robert Street and Minnesota Street as well. And that's all in addition to that multi-year project that has the Kellogg Third Street Bridge shut down. So it's a little bit dicey, but if you just pay attention, go slow, keep your eyes open, you'll be safe. Obviously, that Irish Festival is the thing that's going to be bringing the most traffic from outside of St. Paul into the city. Coming up in a half hour, I'll have a little bit more information on the best way to get there. It's 3 days, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. But for now, I'm going to send things over to Cece. She's got a look at some of the other construction projects that are happening around the metro this weekend.
Over to 35E northbound now. The road will be closed here between 694, which is in Little Canada, 35W, which is in the Columbus area. That project starts at 10 p.m., but say you're going up to Cabin Country during that time, you'll want to know this. To get around that, you can take 694 to 35W to 35, or 694 to 61, and then get back on 35. That project wraps Monday.